is where I live now. It is a very small house. I have 5 children, 3 boys, 2 girls. I think I'm lucky because my husband is very kind. He works hard and is a good father to our children. He still doesn't like to help me in the house though. Sometimes he does. But if anyone comes to our house, he will stop. Like he doesn't want them to see him doing women's work. But I'm trying to make him change, little by little, because I have so much to do. Every day, my day begins at 5 in the morning. I fetch water and gather some wood and start a fire for cooking. I make sure that my family eats their breakfast at 6. My husband goes to the fields before the sun is way up. I see my children off to school, and then I clean the house. Go to the river to wash the dirty clothes. I come back and fix lunch for my husband and take it to him in the fields. Usually, I stay there to help him weed and water the vegetables. In the afternoon, I come home after my sons come home from school and fix food for the family. I feed the animals and make sure everything is clean. I go to bed too tired to think that it will be the same the next day. But I don't complain. This is my role. And it's like this for all of us. I think I grew up knowing this would all happen to me one day. I saw it in my mother. She was just as hardworking, maybe even more. I know things can be different, and that there are things we can all do to make things better for all of us. We cannot stop even when we are pregnant or sick. Even then, most of us don't even have time to go to the clinic. But sometimes, I think this doesn't matter. Going to the clinic is no good sometimes. Many of us just don't want to go there anymore. This empty room has many stories to tell. It echoes with the sadness of women who have come here to learn how to care for their bodies or to get help for the pain caused by hard work and difficult conditions in life. Only to feel disappointed, more pained than when they first came in.
I go into the clinic and I can already hear what they will say to me. It doesn't matter what is wrong, they always say the same thing. And I can hear them say to the other women while I am waiting to.
Just go home and rest.
But
I don't understand why you women won't just rest when I tell you to. You are the weaker sex. You don't work like the men. What is wrong with you? Why won't you just go home and rest and stop complaining?
Sometimes they don't even examine you first. They always say, just rest. But I think of what I have to do when I go home, and I know I can't rest. So I walk away feeling sad because I have taken the time to go to the clinic. And now I just have to stay up longer to get my work done.
Sometimes it is worse if they do look at you. The things that they say, can't say anything to them because I'm scared. I don't want to go back.
Mrs., sinabi ko na bumukha ka kanito. Ano ba naman klaseng bukha ka yan? Ikapi-kapi mo namang ginagawa yan eh.
My husband went with me to the clinic. I thought that maybe, well, they wouldn't say those things if he was around. But they made jokes with him, and it was even worse. And he didn't know what to say.
Oh, masyado kayong maraming iniisip, Mrs. Sobrang pag-iisip lang yan. Oh, Mister, baka naman kulang lang sa alaga kay Mrs.
I have taken my husband with me too, because he also decides on some things concerning me. But the health worker wouldn't let him come into the room with me. And then I couldn't explain to him what the health worker had said, because I was too scared to ask questions when I didn't understand.
My husband doesn't want me to go to the clinic now because he thinks everyone in town will know about our problems.
Oy, alam mo, sabi sa akin nung nurse, may sakit daw ang kapitbahay natin.
Siguro malikot ang asawa. Siguro bilyo.
Well, you already have 4 children. Your wife says she doesn't want any more. I think you need some family planning.
Sometimes, we just want someone to talk to us, to try to find out what's wrong. We want to ask questions, but maybe the health worker won't listen, or we are afraid they will get angry and tell us we are stupid. Most of the time, we are asked to go home and not worry about anything.
Dok, ano bang talagang kailangan kong gawin? Natatakot talaga ako eh.
Masyado naman kayo nervyosa, Mrs. Mga babae talaga. Bakit ba ayaw mong maniwala sa akin?
The women dread most the examination room. You come in here, and you can still hear the voices of the health workers. Still feel the fear and the embarrassment of the women. The examination table is facing a glass window where all the tricycles pass and people walk by.
Don't worry about those people outside. We haven't got time to wait until they go. Just don't look out the window.
But I don't want anyone to see me here.
We have asked the health workers to put curtains to make it more private. But they never seem to listen. Maybe they don't have the money for the curtains. Or maybe they don't think it is important. As we talk about these things, we all know that it doesn't feel right. That we could be treated differently. Sometimes, I know that we should get help for things. But why? We have too much to do to just rest. It is hard to change things. But what needs to happen is really very simple. We need to ask to be treated differently, to ask for help, instead of just accepting our condition the way it is. To see a health worker who understands what we have to do every day. The work we do caring for our families, our homes, the work we do to earn money. A health worker who understands that it's not easy for us to just rest, that sometimes even for us to take time to go to the clinic will mean that we must work later into the night, that the hours we must wait are less hours we have to finish our day.
Maybe a change as simple as keeping our personal information in privacy, where health workers do not gossip and tell others what our problems are.
Or giving us information in a way we understand. Information about what's wrong with our bodies, why we are sick, why things are happening, and what we need to do.
Change as simple as always treating women with respect, using encouraging words, words that make us feel better, words and expressions that do not offend or make us scared.
or helping us make our own decisions about who is with us when we have treatment or what treatment we have.
Change can be as simple as rearranging the examination room so that we have privacy, so that people passing in the streets or other patients cannot see or hear our problems. Maybe these things will help women just like myself get help before it's too late, or even just to make their lives better. Sometimes, as I walk down this road, I wonder if this will happen. I hear that there is this new health worker who has come to the next town looking very cheerful and friendly, finding the time and patience to sit through questions and give some explanations. I hear that he is helping people, he listens and cares, has even changed the examination room just by adding curtains on the window and across the doorway. The women go to that clinic more often these past weeks. They have even started to insist that they get the same treatment from the other health workers. Together, they are making the other health workers start to change. These are just some of the many thoughts that I have as I walk each day down this long and dusty road. Some of the things we have all talked about. I know there are even more who share the same feelings, not just women, but their husbands and families who want to support them, to see them happier and healthier, to be involved in making their lives more comfortable. What we choose to change for the better will definitely make a difference for the lives of many. My journey, our journey, begins right here.